Hello, welcome back. Let us start with our last video for chapter 6, that is life processes. The topics which we have already covered up till now are digestion in plants and animals, respiration in plants and animals, circulation in humans, and transport of water in plants. For all our previous videos, please see the link in the description given below. The topics which we are going to cover today are transport of food in plants, excretion, in that we'll see excretion in animals, excretion in humans, and excretion in plants. So let us start with transport of food in plants. The food made by the leaves through photosynthesis is in the form of simple sugar, that is glucose or sucrose. We know that glucose will provide energy. This food needs to be transported to various parts of plants such as branches, stem, roots, etc. This transport of food from the leaves to other parts of the plant is called translocation. It occurs through phloem and its components such as sieve tubes and companion cells. Remember, in phloem, the food gets transported in both the directions, that is upwards and downwards. In phloem, besides food, other hormones and certain amino acids also gets transported. However, this movement of food takes place by utilizing energy in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. Let us see the mechanism of transport in detail. Materials like sucrose is transferred to sieve tubes using energy from ATP. Water now enters into sieve tubes containing sugar by osmosis. This will increase the pressure in the phloem tissue. Due to this, food will move to those parts of the plant having less pressure in their tissues. This will allow phloem to transport food according to needs of the plants. Here, we are completing transport in plants. Let us move on to excretion. What do you mean by excretion? As we can recall, various biochemical reactions occurs in the cells of our body, like which is given here. For example, glucose plus oxygen will release carbon dioxide plus water and energy. But these reactions may produce toxic wastes in the body. These toxic wastes may be nitrogenous waste. So now, the process of removal of these metabolic or toxic nitrogenous waste from the body of an organism is called excretion. Let us see excretion in some animals. In single-celled animals such as amoeba, the waste materials like carbon dioxide and ammonia are either removed by diffusion or through vacuoles. In earthworm, certain special excretory organs are present which helps in removal of waste. Sometimes skin also helps. Now, let us see removal of waste products in humans. The major waste produced by the humans are carbon dioxide and urea. Carbon dioxide is removed by lungs during respiration, and urea is removed by kidney and entire excretory system. So let us see this excretory system. It consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, urinary bladder, and urethra. So what does kidney do? They remove poisonous substances such as urea, other wastes, and water from the blood. And finally, they excrete them in the form of yellowish liquid called urine. So basically, it cleans our blood, and the cleaned blood is returned back by the renal vein. Observe the diagram carefully. The urine from the kidneys enters a pair of ureters, which are tube-like structures. They carry urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is a storage bag which stores urine. And finally, urine is passed out from the body through the urethra. So let us see in detail main excretory organ of the body, that is kidney. Kidney is bean shaped and is located in the abdomen on either side of the backbone. If we cut open a kidney, following diagram is observed. There is one outer structure which is cortex and one inner structure which is medulla. Each kidney is made up of large number of excretory units called nephrons in the medullary region. Here only one nephron is shown for easy understanding. Let us go in depth of these nephron, that is structure and function of nephron, which is the functional unit of kidney. Observe this diagram very carefully along with all the labels. As you can see, the nephron has a cup-shaped bag-like structure at its upper end, which is known as Bowman's capsule. Inside Bowman's capsule, there are lots of blood capillaries, which is known as glomerulus. On the other hand of glomerulus, tubules are present. The blood capillaries which are found in glomerulus surrounds tubules. So what exactly happens here? First, through renal artery, for location see in the diagram, glomerulus gets dirty blood containing wastes in it. Inside glomerulus, blood gets filtered due to pressure. The filtrate contains glucose, salts, amino acids and urea, and it gets collected in Bowman's capsule. The filtrate then enters tubules where glucose, amino acids, most salts and most water gets absorbed back into the blood capillaries surrounding the tubule. Remember, all urea, some salts and some water remains in the tubules only, and finally they form urine. This urine comes out of the tubule and then enters ureter, then bladder, and finally comes out through urethra. On the other hand, the cleaned blood containing only glucose, amino acids, some salts and some water inside the capillaries are taken back by renal vein. There might be a question as to why can we control the urge to urinate. As bladder is muscular, it is under nervous control, so we can control the urge to urinate. Here, excretion in human beings is completed. Let us see the last topic for this chapter. Excretion in plants. Mainly, four types of excretion is observed in plants. First, the gaseous wastes of respiration and photosynthesis in plants, that is carbon dioxide, oxygen, water vapor, are removed through stomata in leaves, lenticels in stem, and released to air. Second, the plant stores some of the waste products in their body parts. They get rid of these wastes by shedding of leaves, peeling of bark, and falling of fruits. The plants can also get rid of wastes by secreting them in the form of gums and resins. Lastly, plants also excrete some waste substances into the soil around them. Here we are completing chapter 6, that is life processes. Stay tuned to EduTales for more videos. And do not forget to share, subscribe and like our channel. For any queries in this chapter, you can type in the comment section. Suggestions are always welcome.